not knowing how we'll get through this test. But holding on to faith, you know best. Nothing can catch you by surprise. You got this figured out, and you're watching us now. And when it looks as if we can't win, wrap us in your arms and step in. And everything we need you to supply. You got this in control, and now we know that you made a way. When our backs were against the wall and it looked as if it was over, you made a way. And we're standing here only because you made a way.
wedding of Jocelyn Thompson and Cliff Prescott. On behalf of the couple, I welcome you to this celebration of love, unity between two of Christ's absolute best. And I ask that you take a moment to please silence your phones in honor and respect of this beautiful couple. Thank you. You may be seated. Before we begin our ceremony, we're going to open up with a word of prayer, so please bow your head. Eternal Father, our gracious Father, we thank you for this special occasion, unifying two of your absolute best. We ask you, Father, that you will allow your Spirit to enter into this room today as you unify both Cliff and Jocelyn in holy matrimony. We thank you, we honor you, and we praise you. In Christ's name we say, amen.
Amen.
We are gathered here today in the sight of God, in the presence of friends, family, and loved ones, to celebrate one of life's greatest moments. We are here to give recognition to the worth and beauty of love, and to add to our best blessings to the words that will unite Cliff and Jocelyn in holy matrimony. Who gives this woman to be married?
I do.
Marriage is a time-honored tradition and should never be entered into lightly. Jocelyn and Cliff have made a very serious and important decision in choosing to marry one another today, enter into a sacred covenant as life partners. While the responsibility to honor and sustain their commitment ultimately lies between the two of them, each of you gathered here today play a significant part in their roles, in their lives. As a community of support, there may be times that Cliff and Jocelyn will need your wisdom, your guidance, your love offerings. There you go. And encouragement to work through the inevitable difficulties that may lie ahead in marriage. So I ask that all of you choose to love in your prayers, your thoughts, and words, and actions towards them and their marriage, and do all that you can to help nurture and deepen their bond. Jocelyn, Cliff. Similar to tending a garden, the quality of your marriage will be a reflection of the effort that the two of you put into nurturing this relationship. You both have the opportunity to go forth from this day to create a faithful, kind, and Christ-centered bond. We pray for you the wisdom, the compassion, and grace to create a peaceful sanctuary in which you both can grow and live. Cliff and Jocelyn, do you understand and accept this responsibility? And do you come here freely to enter into a covenant of marriage?
I do.
As a symbol of their commitment, both Cliff and Jocelyn have decided to plant a seed as a demonstration of their commitment to Christ and each other. Reading from the book of Matthew, chapter number 13. A farmer went out to sow his seed. As he was scattering the seed, some fell along the path, and the birds came and ate it up. Some fell on rocky places where it did not have much soil. It sprang up quickly. Because the soil was shallow, the sun came and torched the plant. Other seed fell among thorns, which grew up and choked the plants. But still other seeds fell on good soil, where it produced a crop 160 and some even 30-fold. The seed that you both planted in this moment today was sown on good soil. And it will be then your collective responsibility to water and nurture your seed, your marriage, with proper care and touch. As water helps restore and rejuvenate a dying plant, it will be imperative that intentional moments of watering during your marriage are in place, allowing for the rays of sun from the Son of God to grow exponentially in your lives. You have known each other from first glance of acquaintance to this point of commitment. At some point, you decided to marry. From that moment of yes to this moment of yes, indeed, you have been making commitments in an informal way. All those conversations that were held in the car, over a meal at Applebee's, after A-Life, all those conversations that began with when we're married and continue with I will and you will and we will, all those late night talks that included someday and somehow and maybe, and all those promises that are unspoken matters of the heart. You see, all those common things and more are the real process of a wedding. The symbolic vows that you are about to make are a way of saying to one another, you know, all those things that we promised and hoped and dreamed, well, I meant it, every word. Look at one another. And remember this moment in time. Before this moment, you've been many things to one another. Acquaintance, friend, karaoke partners, couple, and now fiance. For you've learned much from one another over the past couple years. Shortly you shall say a few words that will take you across a threshold of life, and things between you will never quite be the same. For after today you shall say to the world, this is my husband, and this is my wife. Both Cliff and Jocelyn have decided to share their personal vows to each other. Jocelyn.
Okay.
So, I really struggle with the thought of trying to express the magnitude of my love for you in front of all of these people. I tend to be a private person, so sharing my feelings isn't always easy. But trying to actually put into words my feelings for you is even harder. When I consider the covenant we are entering into, I wanted to address the promises I'd like to make to you. First, I want to let you know that as a wife, I will submit. Yes, submit. I know that is maybe kind of difficult for some of you to believe, maybe even you. But it's easy for me to submit to you because I know who you're submitted to. When Ephesians 5:25 speaks of husbands loving their wives as Christ loved the church and gave himself for her, I'm reminded of the sacrifices that you've already made for me. You truly love me in that way. And I'm honored to become your wife. You are patient and slow to anger, even when I'm unsure and don't know what to eat. I promise I will try to be more decisive in all of my decisions, even my food ones. Qualities in you remind me of the first man I loved, my daddy. Your work ethic and dedication to your craft pushes me to strive for more on a daily basis. Even when you don't think you're where you're supposed to be, I promise to support you and trust your leadership. I see how far you've come, and with God, I know we'll be on the right path. His plans are better than ours. And each day with you is a reminder of what can happen when you surrender your plans to the Lord.
I don't know how I'm going to follow that up, but I have a mic here. All right. Jocelyn Renee Thompson, first and foremost, thank you, God. Without you, God, nothing, none of this would have been possible. As cliche as it sounds, it's true. Not many of you guys know this, but she knows this. Ever since we first met, I was so enthralled about her that from the first date, I would take notes about her, trying to remember simple details and such. So this is my recollection. So thank you for November 28th for agreeing to go on a first group date with me, which was very fun. Karaoke, and then coming back to my place with the group and playing Taboo. I feel as that was the moment, playing Taboo and her being my Taboo partner, I knew you were supposed to be my girlfriend. Thank you for also forgiving me, as I was nervous at the end of that night to forget to ask for your number. Thank you for letting me express my love to you and not saying I love you back to me. It taught me patience. Thank you for not kissing me for a while. Not making it easy for me, for reteaching me to build first. Thank you for being a friend first. Thank you for beating me at billiards on our third date, as you taught me humility. Thank you for that ride home on that rainy night. Instead of listening to music or gossiping about nonsense, you said, let's listen to this. And you put in a church CD of a sermon that you thought related to my current situation in life. It was the church sermon about the widow who was about to be sold into slavery with her son. She only had a jug of oil left to her name. And how in even our lack, we are blessed. It retaught me about spending quality time instead of just regular time together. Thank you for the Hershey's cookies and cream bar for Christmas. Because it taught me that it's the little things that matter, knowing that that's my favorite candy. Thank you for loving garlic shrimp just as much as I do. And that we can hug and kiss and not be ashamed of our breath. Thank you for July 25th, when I had $7 to my name and I was at a new low. And you took me out to eat at Carrabba's in East Brunswick. And you reminded me that God has my back and that he's not done with me. Thank you. I'm still broke, but I'm not broken. Oh man. Oh, thank you for your prayer on January 1st as I was at another new low, suffering a loss in my business. and you wanted to help me so much that you cried. And you ended your crying. We prayed, and I asked you, why are you crying? And you prayed that you wish you could be a better woman for me so you could help me. She cried because she said, I worked too hard to endure such loss. And she wanted to see better. There's so much more for me to thank you for, but we're on a time schedule right now. But I do want to thank you for saying yes on November 20th when I proposed to you. You said yes to this moment right here, our wedding day. You said yes to empower me to become the man of God, the man of God that God has created me to be for you. You said yes to trust me with your life, your well-being, your heart. So with that yes, I assume the responsibility, and a heavy one at that, but with God, all things are possible. I accept the responsibilities to love you, to support you, to cry with you, to laugh with you, to be your best teammate. I finally know the reason and the meaning of Proverbs 18:22. He who finds a wife finds what is good and receives favor from the Lord. And Genesis 2:24, that says, this is why a man leaves his father and mother and is united to his wife, you, and they become one flesh. You are my daily reminder. You are my daily reminder that God loves me. And in the words of Kendrick Lamar, we gonna be all right. Jocelyn Renee Thompson, I thank you and I love you, and I can't wait to start living life with you.
Cliff, do you take Jocelyn to be your wife?
I do.
Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect her, forsaking all others and holding only unto her forevermore?
Yes, I do.
Jocelyn, do you take Cliff to be your husband?
I do.
Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect him, forsaking all others and holding only unto him forevermore?
I do.
May I have the rings, please? Wedding rings are symbolic reminders of the unbroken circle of eternal love. Within the safety and comfort of a true marriage, love given freely has no beginning and no end. Love freely giving has no separate giver and receiver. Each of you gives your love to the other, and each of you receives love from the other. May these rings remind you of the eternal love of Christ and the lifelong commitment between each of you. Cliff, placing the ring on Jocelyn's finger, repeat after me. With this ring, I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
To honor you.
To be faithful to you.
To keep Christ at the center.
And to share my love.
And life with you.
And always.
Forever.
Jocelyn,
placing the ring on Cliff's finger, repeat after me.
Thank you, sir. It's okay.
With this ring,
I give you my promise.
To honor you.
To be faithful to you.
To keep Christ at the center.
To keep Christ at the center.
And to share my love.
And to share my love.
And life.
And life.
With you.
With you.
Always.
Always.
And forever.
And forever.
And now, having entered into the covenant of marriage by exchanging of the vows and giving and receiving of rings, by the power vested in me by the state of New Jersey, I now pronounce you husband and wife.
Everlasting love for me.